Welcome back. This is your man teacher Jivika. Today also we will be learning division and we have two exercises to complete, right? So first, we have 5.6 to complete. Before going to 5.6, we have to learn division of 10. Division by 10. Example, I have a number here 75 and I want to divide it with 10. So what is the answer I get? Let me divide and see. 75 by 10. 10 7 the 70. I have 5 remainder. So what is the answer I get? 7 as my quotient and 5 as my remainder. Right? So if you see here, it's 75. 7 I get as quotient, 5 I get as remainder. So it's small trick that if you have 2 digit number, 10th digit will be my quotient, 1 digit will be my remainder. Similarly, if you have 3 digit number, let us take a 3 digit number now. 142 divided by 10. So what will be my answer? Let's divide and see. 142 divided by 10. 10 ones are 10, subtract 4, 2. Now 42. 10 fours are 40. Subtract. I get remainder 2. So what is my answer now? 14 is my quotient and then 2 is my remainder. 14 is my quotient, 2 is my remainder. Again, if you see, my last number is my remainder and my first two numbers are my quotient. This is a small trick, children, for directly writing the answer when you divide by 10. So when you divide by 10, my last number will be my remainder and the next two numbers will be my quotient. Similarly, if I do with 3, 4 digit number, 7, 5, 6, 2 divided by 10. What will I get? So we can use the trick now directly. Last number will be my remainder. That is 2. 2 will be my remainder. And what are the numbers here? Apart from 2, I have 7, 5, 6. That will be my quotient. So when you divide by 10, easily you can directly write the answer using this trick without actually doing division. So let us go for 5.6 and write the answers like this. Okay? So come to 5.6, take your textbook. Exercise 5.6, page number 124. Now take your pencils and let's start doing it. I have the questions here. I have two blanks, one for my quotient, one for my remainder. So I should write the quotient and my remainder. Let us start writing. So 75 divided by 10. What will be my quotient? Before writing quotient, we'll write the remainder. So that we can easily find what is quotient. So my remainder will be my last number, 5. So what is the left number here? Leftover number is 7. That will be my quotient. So without dividing, I can directly write the answer using this technique or a small trick. Now I can divide 3 digit number here. So now what is the last number? 0. That will be my remainder here. And then leftover number is 18. That will be my quotient. Similarly, this one, 2 is my remainder, 11 is my quotient, 6 is my remainder, the other 3 numbers, 1, 59 is my quotient. Similarly, 0 is the remainder, 6, 81 is my quotient, 1 is my remainder, 3, 63 is my quotient. Next, now I have 5 digits, but also it's very easy. Last number remainder, remaining number my quotient. 1, 2, 4, 5. Now the next one is 2 my remainder, 6573 is my quotient. So is it not very easy? This thing was really easy. Now let us go for the next exercise. Now we are going to see statement problems. So let us go for exercise 5.7. 5.7, I have chosen few selected questions because in this you have all addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, mixed statement problems. Means some are addition problems,
some are division problem. You have to find which type I have to solve this problem. So first you have to read the question, then you have to decide what should I do to get my answer, then you have to solve. First one, in a school there were 927 boys and 896 girls. What is the total strength of the school? Total strength means I should find both boys and girls together. So here if you see total, that means you have to do addition. Okay, so let me write the statements. Please copy the question from the textbook. Page number is 125. I'm going to write the statements on the board and work the problems for you. So let us start writing the statement. So what should I write? First I should write number of boys. How many boys you have? 927. Next is number of girls. How many girls I have? 896. Now I should add to get my final answer, because in the statement I have find the total. Total means addition. So total strength is, add the numbers here. 7 plus 6 is 13. 1 can. 9 plus 2 is 11. 11 plus 1 carry? 12. 2, 1 carry. Now I have 9 plus 8 is 17. Plus 1, 18. So the answer is 1823. So total number of students in the school is 1823. Now next problem, second one, is again an addition. So you will try that sum. We'll go for third one. There were 4125 mangoes in a heap. The shopkeeper sold 3696 mangoes. Out of them, how many mangoes are left in the heap? That means it's a shop. Okay, shopkeeper has how many mangoes? He has 4125 mangoes. He has 4125 mangoes. In that, how many did he sell? He sold 3696 mangoes. Now what should I find here? The left mangoes. How many mangoes are left? So the key point to remember here is left. If I see the word left, that means I should subtract. So I am doing subtraction here to find my answer. So let us subtract. Can I subtract 5 minus 6? No. So what should I do? I should borrow. So 5 becomes 15, 2 becomes 1. 15 minus 6 is 9. Next, 1 minus 9 I can't do. Again I have to borrow. So 1 becomes 11. This 1 becomes 0. 11 minus 9 is 9, 10, 11, 2. Now 0 minus 6 I can't do. So again I'll borrow. So 0 becomes 10, 4 becomes 3. 10 minus 6 is 4. 3 minus 3, 0. So how many mangoes are left in the shop now? 429 mangoes are left. So this is the third sum. Now we'll go for next, fourth sum. Fourth sum, an excursion was arranged for the students of a school. There were 9 buses, in each of which 52 students travelled. How many students travelled for the execution? Execution means trip, children. You go for a trip, right? From school you go for a trip. Sorry, excursion. Excursion means trip, where the students will be taken for different places from school. For that excursion, there is a school here. In that, they have to students for excursion. Okay, that is trip. They have arranged how many buses? 9 buses. to go for trip. In that one bus, how many students are there? 52 students can sit in one bus. I have to find out how many students totally went for the trip. So they have given one bus, how many students can sit. Now I have to find how many students sat in 9 bus. So what should I do? I should multiply. So let us write the statement for that. First I should write number of buses. How many number of buses I have? I have 9 bus. And number of students in each bus. How many students sat in one bus? 52 students. Now total number of students. You can see total here also. But this is not addition. Here I should find, they have given number of students in one bus. I have to find number of students in 9 such buses. So we should do multiplication. So let us multiply this and get my answer. 52 multiplied by 9. 9 twos are 18. 1 carry. 9 fives are 45. Plus 1, 46. So this is the answer I got. So how many students did we go for the excursion? It is 468 students. Now we'll go for fifth sum.
There are 1256 students in the school. If 4 students sit in a bench, how many benches are needed?
So in this sum, children, they have given the total strength of the students. Is there are 1256 students in the school. In one bench, 4 students can sit. Then how many benches I need for all the students to sit? So I should divide and find the answer here. So I will write the statement, number of students. How many students they have in total? 1256 students. 1256 students. Number of students can sit in one bench? 4 students can sit in one bench. So one bench, 4 students can sit. So how many benches I need? So I should divide and find the answer. So let us divide. 1, 2, 5, 6 divided by 4. 4, 3 is 12. 0, 3 is 5. 4, 1 is 4. Minus 0, 1, 16. 4, 4 is 16. So I got my answer, that is 314 benches. I need 314 benches to make the students sit. Okay, children? So we finished those sums. 6 and 7, you can easily do it by yourself. Read the question, you can understand it easily. So you have to try that. Now we'll go for 8 sum. This is the last sum.
In a library, 12 books are kept on a shelf. If there are 436 shelves, how many books can be kept in the library altogether?
So what should we do here? There is a shelf. In one shelf, how many books are kept? 12 books. Like that, how many shelves you have? You have 436 shelves. So I should find how many books totally I can keep in so many shelves. It is 436 shelves. So what should I do? I should multiply again. Now write the statement. Number of shelves. How many number of shelves you have? 436. How many books are arranged in one shelf? In one shelf I can arrange 12 books. So how many books totally I can arrange? I should multiply the numbers to get my answer. So let us multiply these two numbers. That is 436 multiplied by 12. 2, 6, 12, 1, carry. 2, 3, 6 plus 1, 7. 2, 4, 8. And 6, 1, 6, 6. 1 3 is 3, 1 4 is 4. Now add the numbers. You get 2, 7 plus 6 is 13, 3, 1 carry, 8 plus 1 9, 9 plus 3 is 12, 2, 1 carry, 4 plus 1 is 5.
So how many books I can arrange in 436 shelves? It is 5,232 books. These many books I can arrange in the shelf. Okay, I hope I have cleared all the statement problems. By this, your exercise or your chapter is completed. That is, we completed the division chapter. Children, whichever I have done it here on the board, you can copy it in the classwork. I'll be sending you notes also to copy it. And which I have skipped, you have to work it out in your homework book. Don't use in rough book, work it in your homework book. Any doubts, you can ask me in the interactive session, children. Thank you. Bye.